Hi guys, hope everybody's doing well. I may have accidentally been on eBay and accidentally won a Machinist toolbox. So it's a toolbox. It's got heaps of stuff in it. So I'll take you by. I think I'll have to do a draw to show you what's in the toolbox. And it's got lots of stuff in the top as well. So I'll put you, settle you down, and I'll show you what's in the bottom drawer first as the first video. You can throw your guesses down below to what you think I paid for the whole lot, and it wasn't cheap, let me tell you. eBay's mental. Right, I'll set you all you down just here, and I'll get the first drawer. So I think I'll put the drawer over here, and I'll pull out the things. So the first thing is a heavy duty 13/16 and a 3/8, bit of a weird one that, or a 14/9/14, bit of a multi wrench, bit of a weird one. I've never seen anything like that before. So I'll put that down there. The next one, most of these tools are really vintage. It can't be any earlier than the 70s. But this is a brand new, like new old stock, Japanese 8-inch Kasima or whatever wrench. And it's like crisp as anything. And it's absolutely no movement in them jaws. Absolutely solid. So this is a high quality wrench. Very high quality. But it's... But it's like brand new, so obviously it's not had much use that. There is a tap wrench, Greenfield, Massachusetts, pattern number, made in the US of A. So that's quite a nice tap wrench there actually. So I'll put that down there. And what else is there? There's a little small Archer's Tidy corporation, company or something. Just a little cheapy set of bits made in Hong Kong, so not the highest of quality. I think the guy was cheapskating quite a little bit on his tools. The next one of the things I saw in it, what I really liked, and is this Rathbone Birmingham and Rathbone and Son Birmingham small combination square. And I thought, that's a really nice thing, that. And I've never seen one that size. I mean, Rathbone squares are quite valuable, just the ordinary ones, but I've never seen a short one. So that's definitely a keeper. So I was really happy to see that. That's probably the nicest thing so far. I've not been through these drawers yet, so I'm going through them with you. There is a little set of English-made... whatever they're called, wire cutters or whatever, side dikes. There's a Brahma England, look like, what do you call it, thingy my bobbies. What else have we got here? We've got a little set of wine timings, England, so I think that might be Welsh, that. Little set of miniature linesman pliers. Oh, this is quite interesting. What's this? Moore and Wright, Sheffield, England. Massive head screwdriver. I've never seen anything like that. A small handle and a massive head. That's unusual. I've never seen anything like that before. A pair of V-blocks. Quite slim ones as well. A nice set of V-blocks. No rust. This box has been dry stored for a long time. The guy who got it does house clearances, and he said it was out of a loft. A little file, something Stubbs, England. Little file with a little file handle, that's quite nice. And another one here, PS Stubbs. I don't know if you can see that, PS Stubbs. Another little file. A British, you can tell it's an old box. British number one made, a noble brush. Not seen a brush like that made in the UK for a long time. So that's a bit of fun. What's that say? Bedford, Sheffield, England. Little Bedford file with a, looks like a homemade handle. What's this? I don't even know what that is, to be honest. That's an unusual tool. Moore and Wright, Sheffield. So it's a good maker with a nice handle. Not quite sure what it's made for. It's a bit beyond me, that one. And there's this, another one. It almost looked like cobbler's tools to me. But another Moore and Wright, Sheffield, England. So that's quite interesting. We've got a set of needle nose here. Brit tool, made in England. Little set of needle nose. Bit rattly, but seemed to work. Needle nose. We've got Kruger or something, USA, 1781/7. So I'm not sure what they are. Maybe the Americans might be able to. They look in reasonable nick. Not as much play as the other ones, neither. We're getting to the bottom of this now. This first drawer we've got here, something stubs again, England little file. So we've got four stubs files, must have been a set. And we've got another thingy clip. This is a CK371 Germany, little set of what are they called? Circlip pliers, is it? We've got, I think, looks like a Chinesium little hacksaw. A very, very cheap knife. I don't know what that is, but I can't see how you could possibly use it. Some sort of, oh, that's for that cheap knife. Has that got a date on it? Because that looks like brand new. No, I've not found anything with a modern date on it yet. We've got here, a little injector and a load of little bits of metal, bits and bobs, screwdrivers. So that's a bit of fun. So that's a bit of fun there. What else have we got? We've got a little cheapy Chinesium little screwdriver. We got a Homecraft half inch brush, a little clump. What's that for? Cigar cutter or something? Not sure. Yeah, maybe. Looks like a bit of a freebie. We've got a socket. What does that say there? Stillwire, made in Germany. A little quarter inch extension. Looks like a sort of a 4 or 5 inch one. We've got another Kasima Tools Japan 4 inch. To go with that other one there. We've got a little quarter inch, a little breaker bar, made in Germany, still wire again. So that's a nice little quarter inch breaker bar, like that. We've got two quarter inch Allens, still wire and still wire again. Some more still wire quarter inch. We've got a set of feeler gauges. I can't see the brand. It says made in some England, I think, but I'm not sure about the brand. Slip in number 10. So some feeler gauges. I don't know what that is. Uni. Looks like some sort of file or sanding stone or something. Da-da! A packet of Rizzlers. They're good. Has that got a date on it? Made in GB, Great Britain. No. No date yet. Still, hang on a minute. Has he got a date? No. 1987. May 1987. So I think this box hasn't been used since 1987. I was born in 1985. So that is 2 years before I was born, 37 years ago. Wow, that's a fair bit. 37 years, 37-year-old Rizzler, living the dream. We've got here a Kasima Tools. piece of paper. We're getting to the bottom of this drawer now, guys. We've got, I don't know what that is, something stubs again. Anyone know what that's for? Not got a clue on that one. We've got, oh, what's this? Japan, a little stubby from Made in Japan. We've got a lot of, oh, this is quite a lot actually. High speed steel, Kennedy, Sheffield, England, and Eclipse high speed steel. They look like brand new packs of 10, 32 teeth, and 18 teeth TPI. And what's that one there? It doesn't say high speed steel, and then some loose ones as well. So that's a bit of fun. So I'll put them there. What else have we got? We've got another brush, a Briton 12 mil. So I wonder if that's the same as that one over there, probably. We've got a little cheapy spanner, 7/8, 7/16. Got some more blades, and it's another little Chinesium little kit, and it looks like it's broken. So yeah, that's it for that, guys. This drawer is pretty much empty. So that's the first drawer down. Some nice tools in the first drawer. I really like that Rathbone combination square, and I really like that little quarter inch steel wire little sliding thingamajig. That's really cute. That's a keeper. So yeah, and we got some files, V blocks, and those blades are good. So that's the end of the first video, guys. I don't know what I was looking at, because I've literally just got out of the car. I've driven oh my god, about 180 miles to get this box. I bid on it, I didn't even look where it was, and it was Derbyshire, which was miles away. So I've just driven for 4 hours and 40 minutes to collect this box, so I'm pretty tired. So that's the first one down. Thanks for watching, appreciate it. Don't forget to leave how much you think I paid for the whole box down below in the description. Thank you, thanks for watching, bye.